Now, we will be starting with the measures of money supply. Now, before going to the measures of money supply, suppose you are an individual. Suppose when I ask you that how much money you have, first of all, what you will consider? The ready cash which is available with you. Suppose then for an emergency need you require money, then what you will calculate? Whatever is there at hand, plus you will also see that how much assets you have and how readily you can convert it to money. Like many people have got golds, bonds, shares, papers, all these things. Now, you all know these are known as asset because when you sell, you get a proper price for the product. So if I say how much money you have at hand, first of all, you won't think about your asset. First of all, you will think about the ready money or the ready cash at hand. How much is there at home? Secondly, you will think that this much is there and how much your assets can be converted into money. Thirdly, if you need more money, you will think about the land or your house or your property. You will convert it by selling into money. So if you see the entire thing, I can measure the amount of money supply in different way. First, by the ready cash available, because we don't think about the extremities before. Second, you engulf all the assets you have and how readily it can be converted into money. And thirdly, with your ready cash, with your assets converted, you also think about your own property where you're staying, whether it can be converted into money or not when emergency arises. Similarly, if we see the context of India, that at a certain time in the country, how much money is available or how much money is there in circulation. So, four measures were developed, M1, M2, M3, M4. It will be a little bit difficult for you to understand because you don't know anything about banking. We have not started yet. But I will explain you as much as possible. So, measures of money supply. So, what I said, first of all, what do you calculate? The ready cash. So, M1 means if I want to know that in the country, how much ready cash is available. So it is equal to the currency with everyone and the currency which is used for transactions every day. So money changes hand. The amount of money in circulation is known as currency. Then demand deposit with the commercial banks. Now you know that there are so many commercial banks. You can see ICICI, then Kotak Mahindra, SBI. So in all these banks, people have their bank accounts and they deposit their money. What do you mean by demand deposit? Savings account. Now, whatever we save in the bank, we can easily withdraw whenever we require through check or through the ATM. So whenever we create a demand, we can withdraw some amount of cash from our deposit. So that is why we call it demand deposit with commercial bank. So public have the, if I want to see the ready cash with the public, first of all, I have to take currency. Then I have to take how much money the public have with the commercial banks, which they can withdraw on their demand. And number three, deposits with RBI. Now, RBI or Reserve Bank of India is the central bank. Now, you should know that in every country, there are so many commercial banks. But the father of the entire banking institution or the head of all the banking institution is known as the central bank, which is the apex bank or the top bank, which controls the working of all other commercial banks. Now, the central bank of our country is known as Reserve Bank of India. So, a little introduction to the banking system. RBI is the central bank of our country. different countries have different name for their central bank, but there is only one central bank in every country. Now, what is its purpose? It controls the activities of all the commercial banks, and there are commercial banks, many commercial banks which you find. Now, these commercial banks, now like general public, we are general public, we keep our money with the commercial banks. We have no interaction with the central bank. So, for the general public, who serves as a bank? The commercial banks. We save our money here. Now, you might have a different account in different banks according to your preference, but you have no connection with RBI. But RBI, being the apex bank, or it serves as a banker to all these banks, commercial banks. So, commercial banks, whatever money they profit out or they earn income, they keep it with the RBI. So, RBI serves as a banker to the commercial banks. Commercial banks acts as a banker to the general public. So, whatever deposited with the RBI, if the commercial banks need, they also can take the money on demand. So, that is why all the demand deposits are taken in M1 measurement. So, the M1 is the, tells you, it reveals you currently how much money is in supply. So, it is equal to currency plus the demand deposit of the public. Whatever deposit the public have, which can be withdrawn on demand from the commercial banks. And deposits with RBI means the demand deposits of the commercial banks. So, commercial banks, whatever money they have kept with RBI and which they can easily withdraw when the need arises on demand, is known as deposits with RBI. Now, going to M2 measurement. Now, what I said, that before you think about the ready cash and afterwards you think about the extremities. So, here M2 means the totality, how much money you have over here is M1. So, M1 means all the three things here is added up. When I'm writing only M1, it means all the three things are coming. Plus, postal saving bank deposits. Now, in post office also, you will see the early generation, even now also, many people save their money in post office saving banks. Now, these cannot be withdrawn through checks so easily, just like bank deposits. You can withdraw through checks or ATM, but post office saving bank, if you have, these are not so readily recoverable. So, in the next thing, that is M2 measurement, we take total M1 and the postal saving bank deposits. That means you can recover, but it is a little time taking. You cannot get the entire cash whenever you demand. Now coming to M3 measurement. Now M3 includes M1 plus term deposit. Now term deposit means, if I suppose keep my money with the bank and I say that 3 years is the time period I am keeping with the banks, that means within 3 years I cannot withdraw. So there is a time period with my deposit. Within that time period, I cannot even touch the money. So I have the money, I possess the money, but if I want the money within the 3 years span of time, I cannot take it. So the money is not in ready supply whenever we need. I cannot withdraw it whenever I demand. So all these are known as fixed deposit. When I have deposited the money, but for a fixed time period, that is before the time period, I cannot recover that amount. And these deposits are known as term deposit. They are not readily in supply, but if you want to see the total money supply, definitely term deposits also come, because after 3 years it's your money and definitely it will be supplied back to you. So M3 is M1 plus term deposit. So if you see from M1, M2 to M3, we are going to measure, we are measuring money, but first we take the easiest source of money, then we try to take some of the sources which are not that easy, but still it contributes to money supply. Then we go to all those term deposits that are not so easily recoverable, but definitely they give the money, they actually supply back money. And M4 is the last, which includes the totality of money supply, that is M1 plus postal saving plus term deposit. So M1 is common in everything. M1 is the most liquid form of money supply, most readily available. And if you want to see how much total supply is there, whether readily available or not, time taking. But the total money supply, if you want to see, it includes M1, postal savings deposit, as well as the term deposit. So just as I gave you one example, that if you are in need of money, first you look at the most ready source. That is, how much is there in your pocket, or how much is with your mother or father. You just take that money. Then if you need more supply, you take the assets and think about selling those assets and converting them into money. So slowly you go into all those techniques which definitely returns back or gives you money supply, but not at the present moment. Same thing is over here happening with money supply. We are calculating, these are the different methods or measures of calculating money supply. M1 gives you the ready source of money with the country, within the country. M2 gives you not that ready source, but still you can consider it because it also will add on to the money supply. M3 also adds on to the money supply, but the money is not that readily available. It is a little bit time taking to convert into money supply or money at hand. And M4 gives you the total how much amount of money is in supply, that takes M1 plus how much money is there with the postal savings bank, although not readily available, but still it gives back money. And then the term deposit, which are fixed for a certain time, after that it is available, but definitely it contributes to the money supply later on.